Hey guys, and welcome to another Marvel video. This one's more of a kind of rant than anything else, so don't take this as any news or anything. But this is what I feel are the two biggest problems with Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3, The Black Order. Like, these two things have been around the whole time, the whole game. They've never changed. It's part of the actual game design, but I think they are very, very bad choices, and they're not fun. Like, you know, these two issues. Basically, the first one is leveling. I'm sure all of you guys know leveling in Marvel is a piece of shit. Like, okay, early levels, like, you know, when you first start playing the game up until, like, your first hero up to, like, level 80, that's fine. Anything beyond that level, like, after you finished Ultimate, it's a fucking train wreck. Like, it's so hard to level heroes up. Like, I've leveled all my heroes up to 100, and then to 150, and then to 200... and now I gotta do it to 300. I'm like basically a quarter of the way there, and I just don't feel like doing it. Like, it just, and it's the same method that we have. Like, there's no, they never add like a better way to level your heroes. And then they've kind of got this constant like F you in your face. I mean, look at this new event, right? The Glorious Gauntlet Gifts, right? They're giving out like 5 enhancement cubes for like a challenge. Dude, I can buy that with, like, what, 250,000 credits? I mean, all the new gauntlets give you, like, millions just for completing them. Like, I just got, like, 50 million the other day just for doing a few gauntlets. Like, you know, like, the reward doesn't make sense. Like, enhancement cubes, like, they're worthless. I mean, the ultimate experience cubes are a little bit better, but they're so scarce. I mean, you can only buy, like, what, 10 of them in the shield depot? It's, like, hardly worth it, to be honest. Like, was it 10 or 100? I'm not even sure. But it's, like, no, it's not enough. It's not enough. Even buying the enhancement cubes in the shield depot, like, when you actually have the money, like, you have to, like, wait for that slider to hit 999. Do you know how long that takes? I'm sure you do. If you've leveled like that, it takes a long damn time. There's just no way to actually level in this game, like, in a fun, enjoyable way. I mean, I think the beginning part of the game is fine. They shouldn't touch that. Like, leveling up in the early game, that's fine. Like, you know, you hit a lot of, like, steep curves very quickly. There's ways to get past it by leveling through, like, rush rifts. That's fine. But, like, once you finish the game, I just want to level my heroes to maximum so I can try different teams. Why do I have to, like, struggle to level everything? I mean, look how they gave us Infinity Thanos, who's, like, a very cheesy character that you can just, like, destroy through everything. You can't actually struggle with anything in the game, having a hero like that on your team with Phoenix and just, you know, you just, like, just steamroll everything in the game. Everything in the game is now easily doable, there's no problems, but you can't level all your heroes up to maximum. I think, like, once you have beat, like, let's say, the DLC on, like, Ultimate, like, after unlocking Infinity Thanos, you know, beating the game in Ultimate, you should unlock a way to purchase Ultimate Experience Cubes in the Shield Depot for, like, a really cheap price. It's like, oh, thank you, you made it through the game. You want to try some new heroes? Here, do this. Instead, like, oh, you want to try some new heroes? Okay, cool, you're going to have to spend 10 hours farming the Whites, Isle 8s, to get those Team Experience Gems. And that's if you're, like, lucky, because that it's not even guaranteed drops. It's kind of, like, all just randomized, using one really old, like, rift to kind of just, you know, and hope you get these damn experience gems, and you need 20 of them now, which takes a really long time. Pretty sure it's going to probably take more than 10 hours. I mean, it took me like 10 hours back in the day, if I recall, remember, but I've been getting like more of them as I've just been playing on, doing random things, right? But I'm at like 310 hours now. You can't expect every single player to play 310 hours, and I don't even have all my heroes at level 300 yet. I mean, granted, I've been doing like the farming back way back then, so things were a lot more difficult back then. It would have been easier if I had to like play the game in its current state. I could probably finish it in like 100 or 150 hours. But the point is, I really think that leveling needs to be fixed for once you finish the game. Like, once you've gotten, like, let's say, a minimum amount of heroes to maximum, or even, like I just said, as soon as you've beaten the game in Ultimate and you've unlocked, like, Infinity Thanos, you should get a way to have, like, an easy leveling. You know, not, like, too cheesy, like, okay, cool, boom, everyone's maximum, game done. But I think something a little bit easier that's not going to take, like, 20 hours just because, you know, like, I looked at the comments and everyone is so fed up with this game and burnt out because they leveled everyone to 300. And I'm quite certain if I have to level everyone to 300, I'm probably not even going to want to play this game anymore. Like, I'm just going to be like, I'm done. I am done. If they don't announce a new DLC, I'm done. Screw your little events. I'll come for the costumes. That's it. Anything else, I am done. Give me a way to level up my heroes. Like, that doesn't, like, revolve around me doing some random level 48 rush rift over and over and over and over and over and over until I freaking pass out or something, or, like, one of the gauntlets. I believe the level 180 gauntlet is also quite good for leveling. It's just a little harder if you're playing with lower level heroes or heroes that you're not used to. Yeah, I think they should fix that. Like, leveling is a freaking mess in this game, dude. It is a mess. Any casual player probably doesn't have heroes at level 300. I can guarantee that. Like, a really casual player probably even quit the game right after, like, the first difficulty, because most people play, like, just the first difficulty. Why play it over and over? But that's a whole different story. The other big problem with this game is ISO 8s. I've seen some people raging, and, like, I agree with them. Like, I would rage too. Like, it hasn't happened to me personally, but what I've seen happen, I'm not sure if there's actually, like, a fix for this, or if it's, like, you do kind of get it, but I'll get to the point now. So, when you are trying to get specific ISO 8s, let's say there's a gauntlet, right? There's an ISO 8 reward, but halfway through the gauntlet, let's say you have to, like, do 10 streaks. Let's say, like, the 6th streak, you get the message, oh, you are out of storage. Anything that you get ISO 8 related now is not coming. It's gonna just disappear. It's gonna, like, go poof. Like really? Like, really? They said they finished the game and they didn't get the... It counted that they got the reward for the ISO 8, like the special one for the reward for the gauntlet, but it wasn't in their storage. Like, can you imagine that? Like, you just unlocked this ISO 8, but because your storage was full, it's gone. Like, it's not there. I don't know if they ever solved it. If you guys have dealt with this issue and you figured out a fix, or, like, or it actually does come back somehow, I don't know if you, like, replay it or something, let me know in the comments below. I'd be very interested to see if there was a fix for that. But a bunch of people were upset about that. Like, a lot of people. Like, So, I think this whole ISO 8 having a capacity kind of storage limit, like, of 1,000 is ridiculous. I mean... Like, I have, like, two solutions for this, but honestly, the first one should be, like, the go-to solution. Remove the cap. Remove the limit. Why do we have to have a limit? Like, why? For what reason? Like, we literally use these to craft and make more others. Why do we have to constantly get rid of them just so that we can have more space? Like, I mean, I don't get the whole point. Like, you know, sure, having 10,000 is a bit insane, but you can still find what you need if you still have to manage this crap all the damn time. Or at least give us a way for, like, example, like the colored ones. Like, if you want to keep your stupid limit of 1,000, which I don't think you should, because just removing that limit's like the golden method of just fixing this. But I think you should also get an option to, like, block getting certain ones or something. Or, you know, like, for example, all the colored ones, like the everything but white and rainbow. Like, I want to block those. I don't need those anymore. I never use them. They're worthless, because you can get those same effects on a rainbow and you can get two of them for, you know, just basically two for the price of one. Like, why am I not going to get one for, you know, on, like, one effect on one ISO 8 when I can have an ISO 8 that has two of them with the effect that I want already? Yeah, sure, it takes a little harder to get the certain effects that you want, but at a certain point, you don't need any of the colors anymore. Like, I've never used any of the other colors besides rainbows and the white ones, because the white ones obviously give you the team experience and different grinding options for, like, credits or like, you know, rainbow gems, or, you know, just more team experience gems, like increased white drops or whatever. So white ones you kind of need, and the rainbow ones you need. The other colors you don't need. So I think either, like, let us block those other colors, or give us a way to, like, do something interesting with those colors. Like how I mentioned in a previous video long ago, to merge colors from, like, orange and red and make a new rainbow ISO 8 for, like, a small little price or something. I don't know. Like, give us, like, a little price or something. It costs, like, this many credits and this much fragments or whatever, or the dust or whatever. And then you can craft your own rainbow ISO 8s with the two effects you want. Because right now the colored ones are completely useless, in my opinion. So I really think those are the two issues of this game. And they make the game a worse experience, in my opinion. Like, everything else in the game is really fun. Those two things hold the game back immensely. Besides, like, the bugs and the glitches that the game comes with, because, Jesus, it comes with enough of those. But these are the two things that the game design actually includes, that, like, you know, its foundation. And it just, I think it should be better. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. What do you think these two problems, like, how they could be fixed? Do you agree with my methods? Is there something that I completely missed? I don't have any foresight on, or... You know, let me know in the comments below. Let's talk about this and how they could actually make this game better, or a sequel game. Like, let's say if they're working on Marvel Ultimate Alliance 4, how could they use our advice to make the game better? Like, if they had to make this game over and do a new different story and stuff, what would you suggest they do to make the game a better game to play? Let me know in the comments below. I'll see you guys in a future Marvel video. Thanks for watching.